12 scarcity or 4 scarcity? I need your response. Which one will rob you through? It's a topic today called 14 millions in agribusiness. We're in an economic environment where we do a lot of research. But guess what? Who are the people who make bulk of the money? The people in our 12. They use our knowledge, they scale it up in practicals, and make so much. So today, I'm speaking to you briefly on 14 millions. You must foresee the money before you actually get the money. I've been privileged to do a number of projects. I once boiled corn, so I brought the knowledge of sweet corn from Iowa, and currently we are the largest sweet corn producer in Nigeria, and we sent sweet corn out all over the country. One particular event happened. I produced corn, our normal corn, and the market was not so well, and I decided to go to an event, and in the event, they had about 6,000 people in attendance overnight. I took 7,500 corn there. We boiled 7,500 corn, sold at 50 naira, and sold that in one night. That we generated over 500,000 naira one night selling boiled corn. It's not about the money, it's about perspective. It's about looking at how things are done. I just simply went to a fair in Iowa and I saw how people were boiling corn, and we came back to say it can be done here. So we didn't even have access to sweet corn there, but we used our local corn to do that. I'm saying to all of us, there are many things available here that we just need to improve on. We don't need to go to America now, but we can go online. The ticket is expensive now, but we can go online, copy and paste. Now, I'll be speaking to this very, very fast. I have some things to show. Now, so most of the times, we as agri practitioners, we focus on doing the job. But this year, the economic advisor of President Buhari did say in a publication, January 2021, that Nigeria spent 1.85 trillion on food importation. 1.85 trillion. So if you are looking at where is the money, 1.85 trillion is available, that if we produce locally, we will be able to give that. Next one. Now, Bureau of Statistics said in 2019 we spent 22 trillion of food. 22 trillion of food. You and I contributed that. Next one. This amazes me. Everybody here contributed to this. We spent 4.6 trillion eating out in 2019. 4.6 trillion. Mama put it not there. Yarisi, Mama Chineke is not there. It is the eatery. You and I contributed 4.6. That's a lot of money. My question to you all, how much came into your pocket out of 4.6 trillion? So these are figures that we should pay attention to. How did we get here? Briefly. First, private sector. Private sector has not tapped into the opportunities involved available in the agri sector. The private sector is waiting for government. Government is waiting for private sector. That is why we are where we are. But I'll tell you good news at the end of the event. An American company is also providing the opportunity for 100,000 youths to benefit from it. Government. Government has quite a lot of beautiful initiatives. Developed, you know, world-class projects. But guess what? They are too big for the practitioners to embrace, because our agriculture is not like the American agriculture. It is small and medium. But guess what? We do very large projects, and we have abandoned projects all over. But that's for the private sector. That's for institutions like this. And we have religious bodies. Imagine if four of the major religious bodies, Christians, Nasbats, every year millions gather at least twice a year. Millions. And they do outreach, they give food. Most of the food giving is not produced locally. Please let me say this. In America, it's not everything that Americans that is produced locally. I'm aware America exports soybean and maize to Mexico. America is about the fifth largest producer of tomatoes, but they specialize in processed tomatoes, the tomatoes used for paste, while they do a lot of importation from Mexico. So they import fresh tomatoes from Mexico. They are still one of the largest producers of tomatoes, yet they are importing, but they facilitate trade. They leverage on their comparative advantage. Our comparative advantage can be leveraged to export while we still take care of ourselves. We should not fully ban importation. We need to stay with each other. That is how the world is thriving. America is America because America has a large heart. So Nigeria, we need to have a large heart also to stay for. Yes. So we need to move from eating big amala to becoming producers and exporters. Now, this figure was released by the federal government 2016 to 2020, talking about the deficit. Yes, hold on here. Yeah, talking about what we produce and the gaps. Now, with this, it shows the opportunity. We need 4 million metric tons of rice, wheat, maize. But what I've done, next slide, please, is just to break it down. Because many of us don't know where to get the money. Where is the money? And so if you say we want to produce 4 million tons of rice, that means we will need 1 million hectares going by Nigerian yields, not Asian yields. So what that means is we will spend seeds, 5 billion is waiting for you, not what is currently being produced. The gap that needs us to step in. For the youth here is an opportunity for you. 5 billion are waiting for you on agrochemicals, 30 billion, fertilizer, 52 billion, tractor service, just waiting on tractors. These figures you see here are our living. If they are not on nylons alone, 4.7 billion naira is waiting for the grabs. So when you hear where are the opportunities, we need to break down the gaps and make it happen. Yeah, so this is the summary of some amount of money on just 4 items waiting for you. Bill Gates currently is, according to Forbes, owns 242,000 acres. So gradually from technology is looking into our sector. So if Bill Gates is looking into the sector, then it's good for you. And if I'm not aware of anybody else which has Bill Gates here. So we should look at the trend. Yeah. Now, value chain. We must have a value chain approach. We know that in theory, but in practical, what is the value chain? So if government says, go and plant rice, it's not about going to plant rice, it's the feed mill, it's the tractors, it's the logistics, it's the processing, it's the feed mill. This is how we should approach it. Beef, I went for the US to West Africa event that happens, I think, every 2 years or 3 years. I met a man whose business is to import a special beef. And I'm like, is it not the cows that we eat? But a special beef is, he has the sole right to take it across West Africa. Beef is not beef. We need to pay attention. There's a huge value chain there. Let's move. Packaging. This is where we need a lot to be able to create jobs. Logistics is huge. During the lockdown, it was very clear to all of us that we needed logistics. Government was running after mile 12 to say provide peace, distribute the food. Many of us are going to logistics. Google, American companies, they are trackers, they are willing to come to Nigeria through you. That's why the small businesses. Marketing. This will make you money than anything. Food is wasting everywhere. We don't need, it's not rocket science, we don't need technology. We've created a platform, African Farmer on NG, where you stay, any state you are, whatever is wasting, just take a picture, get the variety, get information, put it on the platform, and let somebody in Lagos contact you to buy. You are not moving anything. We need to begin to work together now, leverage on technology. Aggregation. Aggregation is the middleman. Nestle has changed its policies now to accommodate small companies. Move on. How can you come on board? We need to relieve farmers. We need to support farmers. We don't need you to really start another farm. We need you to collaborate with existing farmers so that we can scale productivity, not production. Nigeria is too much focused on production than productivity. So we must use 1 hectare that we are using to get 5 tons, 4 tons, to use it to get 15 tons. Fortunately, there's a company, American seed company called Pioneer. Pioneer is still the best seed in the country. I've been using it for 8 years. That's what everybody uses. Everybody gets from 8 tons to 4 tons, maximum 5, you will get 8 tons from Pioneer seed. So, not at the case where, you know, we say technology is bad. No, technology is bad. Same height, same height. And I don't think I'm very conscious of GMO. The only thing we talk about the America is GMO. There are 1,001 things coming out of America that is not GMO. And by the way, I'm not for GMO, no, I'm not against GMO. But I can tell you, for our food security, we need to embrace some GMO. Our silos are empty. If we don't have rain like California, how would we can't feed for 6 months? So we need to fill those silos. And by the way, GMO is improved technology. How many farmers will grow seeds and you will know you want to be praying? You will rather buy seeds that will reduce your prayer and allow you to go marketing. So please, don't let us close our minds to technology. Open your mind, because that's where the next thing is. Now, information marketing, we're in an academic environment. Please, can I have my materials? Now, information marketing is whatever knowledge you specialize in. There are many PhD professors here. Whatever your knowledge is, please, there's information marketing. According to Forbes, February 30, 2019, it's a 1.7 trillion market. And what is information marketing? By the way, I'm not selling this yet. Well, it's online. But I'm telling you, how can you package your knowledge? I was broke sometime, and I wanted a millionaire. All I did was to package my knowledge in some materials, offered it, and I went for a speaking engagement, and I did 1.5 million in 4 days. And that product is still selling. There's a way to package your knowledge, which is where FUNAB should pay attention to. All professors now should learn, like common mistakes in agribusiness. How to start and grow. Many of us know it. How to invest in Nigerian agriculture. But the way to package it, this knowledge is online, and the Americans have gone ahead of us in that. That is working for me. How do I get a day that I don't get credit, even while I'm sleeping? Because I have multiplied my knowledge in products that is paying others. Any of my seminars will do a minimum of 1 million. If I need cash today, if I want to buy tickets, I'll just say, oh, I want to have an event, and ticket money will be fine. So some of us are not struggling because we've learned mostly from the Americans. Next one. Now, this is part of this. How to raise funding for any agribusiness in Nigeria within 6 weeks. You must be able to communicate your knowledge. These trainings are available that you can implement. Move to the last one. I want to challenge us with this as I close. Fuel scarcity or food scarcity? I need your response. Which one will be more beautiful? Fuel scarcity or food scarcity? Food scarcity. So we need to up our game. If we don't want food scarcity, by the way, next year is going to look very good because of climate change. So we need you all to step in. And next week, this Saturday, we're having an event. Our MasterCard Foundation is partnering with Sterling Bank. And they are supporting 100,000 youths below the age of 35. MasterCard Foundation is an American company. And the fund is available. But guess what? We don't want Nigerian youths to take this money. So Sterling Bank is collaborating with us to give 10,000. I know FUNAB has the alumni group. Out of 100,000 in about 2 years, just 10,000 have accessed this money. And I'm appealing to you on Saturday, online, 1 hour, just come get it. The alumni, please share it with me. The flyer, but for 500,000, can go as low as 250,000 to 5 million on collateralized money. Coca-Cola also is funded. The American companies are pushing a lot in Nigeria. My appeal to us is that instead of thinking it's difficult, can we come and embrace this? We've partnered with Steady to take two of the major stumbling blocks, access to market and a support system. So if you come on Saturday online, we'll be able to, you know, get that across to you. I'm appealing and I hope our DBC man, please help us share this information. If the foundation does not give this money out, they are going to take it to another country. I know two brands that we've received the physical funding, they went into other countries because they were not willing to do the publicity. This is an opportunity for FUNA, because the practical knowledge here is not in other institutions. It's not theory. FUNA does practical. I want to say thank you for this opportunity, and I believe that this will be a beginning of a new